Hello everyone. Welcome back to STEM with Chantel.
Hi, I'm Firefighter Steve Eilerman. We are here at Station 20 of the Lexington Fire Department. We're going to talk about the Christmas light show that we put on every year. So the Christmas light display that we have here, it's evolved over the years. It started back in the early 2000s. It was a pretty rudimentary back then, but is grown by leaps and bounds, and it's become pretty sophisticated. As of last year, we added a new controller device, and it's allowed us to do a lot more things, and it's just become something that everybody around town seems to like. So I think one of the things that makes this light show really special is how it's grown. It was pretty small when it started early on, and a lot of the firefighters here saw the amount of joy that people were getting out of it, and they started adding to it out of their own pockets, which, it really became kind of a what were they going to add next year, and it's really grown and become, it held a special place in not only the people who get to enjoy its hearts, but everyone here at Station 20 as well. Being as intricate as set up as this is, we need to get started pretty early. So generally speaking, we start in the, we're usually getting the lights out sometime in October, and then throughout the next month, the lights go up. Every shift works on it here and there, and usually by middle of November, we got a pretty good idea of where we're at and pretty much done. But it's a team effort. Everybody has a hand in it, and it's become quite a big tradition around here. So as you can probably imagine, there's quite a number of lights. I'm not sure how many, but we have, safe to say, thousands of lights out there. And each one of them is plugged into a separate circuit, and they have a separate channel. So like all the candy canes, they each have red and white on them, and then they'll have a dedicated channel so that we can make them fire whenever we want to. So it allows us to really customize a show, and the mega tree that we have there, we can create waves and have it go in a circle and back and forth. And it's all because of the discrete channels that each of the lights are plugged into. It allows us to really do a lot more and create a really fun show for everybody. So as far as how we actually control the lights here at the station, as of last year, we started using a new program called Light-O-Rama. It's a lot more sophisticated than the one we had previously. The other system had gotten some age to it, so we've upgraded, and it's allowed us to be a little, it's allowed us to do a lot more and customize the show and make it a lot more fun. For the most part, we are able to purchase and download the songs. And what that allows us to do is it gives us pre-recorded or pre-programmed songs. They have light channels that are already configured to look good with whatever song that may be. So for an instance, this is a Holly Jolly Christmas. And up here we have every single one of our channels. So, we'll have the right dormer, left dormer, the mega trees down here, and the timeline down here lets us play the song, and then we can make the lights fire in any of the channels that we want to whenever we want to. We can customize it. For the most part, we don't do that. We use whatever Light-O-Rama has on their website, but we can make our own versions of the song if we wanted to. Once we have our songs programmed, either customized or just from the website itself, then we put it into a show. And each night we play a different set of songs. We'll usually have anywhere from 5 to 6 songs, and then we have one night where we play all the songs in order. I think for this show, this is show A, and we have 6 songs on here. We can put them in any order that we want to, and once we have our show of the songs in the order that we want, all we do is save it and then use schedule editor to make it start and stop whenever we want to. So really, this thing is self-sufficient once it gets going. We have the lights come on at 5:30 every single night. They automatically shut off at midnight and we don't have to do anything else. It's very self-contained and self-sufficient. It's really, really cool. So with the amount of lights that we have out here, we need several controllers to be able to control all that and make them sync together. We've got two of the controllers sitting right here. We've actually got two on the other side, and each one of these boxes has 16 discrete channels. So each set of lights that we have out here plugs into a different channel, and we can control that with the software and make them fire whenever we want. Make them in sync, make them go alternating back and forth, can really do whatever we want with them. But 16 channels apiece, so that gives us 64 channels that can fire and do different things at different times. It's really cool.
So each one of the channels that he talked about earlier go to certain different boxes that we have scattered throughout the yard and the side of the building. So each one of these channels represent, every one of these plugs represents another channel, so that for the green tree, for instance, here we have four different channels on it, so four different times we could have the lights flashing. So that's why we need the four different plugs, four different channels. And then as you go down each side of the bushes, the candy canes, the mega tree on the other side, all the plugs, we have different channels and they're all numbered. So we have to hook up certain extension cords to the certain plugs so that everything, when the show goes on, it makes sense and things firing at the correct time. There's a very long list of paperwork, many clipboards, many diagrams that we have to follow to get all the different lights to fire at the correct time. If we were just to plug them up randomly, we would still have a light show, but things would flash all at different times and wouldn't be as good of a show as we could create. So with this, this gives us the very best show that we can give everybody.
So in order to coordinate the lights with the music, it really wouldn't work one way or another just having the lights or just having the music. We sync it and we use a FM transmitter that allows people to sit in their car and tune into 91.1 and they can listen straight from there. We also have a speaker set outside that plays the music as well, so they can do either or. They can enjoy it from their car. As you can probably see and hear, they're running around on the concrete and enjoying it out there as well.
Malekilikimaka is a thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Malekilikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Malekilikimaka is a thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Malekilikimaka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas to you. Here we go. Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night.
Melikilikimaka is a wise way
to say Merry Christmas to you. Melikilikimaka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway.
Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright,
the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikalikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas.
A very Merry Christmas.
A very, very Merry, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you for tuning in from the STEM with Chantel.
Here at the Jessamine County Public Library.
Be sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and share this video so you can be aware of the next time we upload. Thank you.